among the many Christmas cards that I received and listening to one young lady who was born and reared in this church. She came down to get a New Year light. And now when I came out of the pulpit, she said to me, "I'm going to do better next year. I'm coming back to my church. I'm not much on resolutions. I just like to see you do your duty. You must work the work of him that sent you while it's day. For the night come when no man can work." I just want to tell you another little story about another one of my boys, and I have hundreds of them. Andrew Martin. He said, "I don't get to church like I should, but I don't have a father anymore. You're my father." It was such a compliment. And I have a lot of boys and girls like that. And it says, "I watch over you." It's nice to have somebody to think about you. And I wonder, do you appreciate somebody that thinks about you? That nothing changes their mind. Helen Steiner wrote a little poem. "Give us through the year quietness of mind." And I'd like to pass this on to you tonight in no excitement. I'd like to tell you to get yourself together. "Teach us," he said, "to be patient. Endure something. Don't try to get a lot of new things, but just learn a little patience. Maybe you are better than somebody else. Maybe you don't have any faults like they have. But whatever their shortcomings are, be a little patient." And she said, "Teach us." I want you to say it different. "Teach me to be patient. And always to be kind." Some of you don't know what kindness is. You're digging ditches. You have ugly words. You're ready to say something unkind. And one of the things that it really disturbs me, when folk call me and ask me, "What do you know?" That's a sign that they want to find out something about somebody else. Teach me to always be kind. And with all the bad, to have something good to say about everybody. Give me a reassurance that the Lord is on my side. Every now and then, I want to know, in the middle of all the criticism and the things that happen, I want to know, are you with me? When everything goes wrong, give me faith to know that everything is going to be all right. Nothing, no darkness, no clouds, no poverty, no distress, no sickness is going to last always. Not even a grave. I don't care who don't believe it, but I don't believe the grave is going to hold us. Amen. Give me hope and give me courage to face tomorrow, whatever might come. Let me be a real soldier. Stand up to it. And know that somehow and some way, God's going to bring us out. And then let me get in the quiet. Shut out all the folks. So many folks aren't going anywhere. Maybe I have to shut off some parties or shut off some social thing, but let me get in the quietness. Glory. And then let me feel your presence. You can. I wonder tonight, do you believe it? I see some folks shouting and don't mean anything. And I don't care anything about folks shouting all the time. But every now and then I want to feel your presence. I want to know. I want to know. I want you to fill me with something. Fill me with a joy, kin, and peace. Peace on the inside when everything going wrong. Fill me with peace. Amen. Help me to be real. Don't let me be a hypocrite. Help me to be real. Not just on Sunday, but on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, help me to be real. Can the Lord depend on you? When waves of affliction sweep over the soul and sunlight is hidden from view, somebody will fall out with you. If ever you are tempted to fret, sometimes you wonder why so and so act like that. But look back and see where God brought you from. Bless him.